Hey, Remote Pilot 101, Jason here. We've known for a long time you shouldn't just directly call up an air traffic control tower and ask for permission to enter or fly into their airspace. There's a system for that. This is why the LANCE system was created. This is why we have authorizations and even waivers for long-term airspace authorizations. So the FAA recently had this, we'll call it secret memo, surface. And it essentially said just that, but it was talking about in reference to recreational pilots. Let me show you that memo here and I'll read it to you real quick. I'm skipping down to paragraph 3. Air traffic facilities should not authorize or approve any recreational flight. The purpose of this implementation plan is to diminish the need for calls to towers from any recreational operator requesting to fly in controlled airspace. The authorization and restrictions for recreational UAS operators will be the national authorization for fixed sites in controlled airspace as detailed below. And it goes through to detail where we can actually fly, model fields, everything else, and the systems we can go through. This is talking about recreational pilots. We know we go through LANCE or some sort of authorization system. The problem was happening was all these rec pilots, we'll call them, were wanting to operate in this little class Delta airspace, would pick up the phone, call the tower, and the tower operators, the air traffic controllers, were complaining they were spending more time on the phone talking to drone pilots than they were looking at the radar, looking outside for manned airplanes as well, which is what they're paid to do. They're really paid to control the airspace, so they got to balance all those plates is what they're really doing. Where they want to focus, though, is with the Part 107 operators, their authorizations, if they even need to speak to them at all. Usually, you don't. So recreation pilots, there's this memo. I imagine the FAA is going to announce it soon. This came out on May the 11th. It was leaked. We don't know when this will become law or how this will become law, but it's something I want you watching for. Most of you watching this are Part 107 commercial operators, but I know you have some friends who fly recreationally who might be calling towers. Let them know that, hey, you're not going to get away with that much longer. There's other ways to get through this. There's going to be a link to this secret memo, we'll call it, beneath this video as well if you want to read it in its entirety. I know you'll have some questions about this, just like last week when we dissected ADS-B and everything else. So please leave myself and this great team here at remotepilot101.com a comment on YouTube, on Facebook, and you know you'll get a response from us. So we can't wait to read your comments. We'll see ya. Remote Pilot 101 is the most successful Part 107 test prep course on the market with over 18,000 tests passed. It's one price and you get our updated initial and brand new recurrent course for life. It's two courses for the price of one and it's for life. See the actual test questions, learn the material, take the practice quizzes, all at your own pace through our easy videos you've already grown to love. Visit remotepilot101.com to become a member for life and learn more.